Well,
Peter,
you made it.
Yeah, I'm still in one piece, more or less. So it's the end of us coming to the market. It's definitely not the end of the season, so to speak, because our season doesn't come to an end. So Friday we had a high of 27 degrees and a low of 12.
Wow.
And that killed the majority of our summer crops. Although there's actually a few that somehow made it, but it's the end of the summer season for sure. So now it's back to the old greens and potatoes and onions and that kind of stuff, which is, this time of year is really good. And cabbages and broccoli and cauliflower for now.
So you're going back upstate?
Going back upstate to begin the new cycle. Get ready for new year.
So what does that mean?
It means start buying seeds, you start planning, you start filling out applications to get guys on visas, start finalizing paperwork for your NOFA. There's a whole bunch of applications that I have to fill out for the new year, such as green market, organic. And so all of that stuff has to be done by me, so gotta get to it. Or you have no farm. No paperwork, no farm.
What do you have to do to the land, to the soil?
The soil now rests. I mean, it's being cleaned up and the outside has been about 90% is already harvested. There's about 10% left to harvest. If we get it before the snow, we got it. If we don't, then we might get it in the spring if it doesn't get too cold. And then the greenhouses or the high tunnels get cleaned up some more. They're mostly all planted now. And so now it's more or less a semi-rest. The ground rests. Goes into a hibernation for sure.
When do you get to rest?
When do I work less time?
Yes.
Starting 2 weeks from now. I'll start working a little less. So here's your honey nut. So it looks like a butternut, but it's a cross between a honey nut and I think a carnival actually, or something similar to that. It's a lot sweeter, a lot nicer tasting than that. More, a little bit sweeter, not quite as sweet. So that's a rage now because it's a single serving size, and the chefs can put it on the table like that. So there's a lot of people breeding the baby stuff now.
Can we go through some of the winter stuff and what's going to be here?
Yeah, sure. In the winter, we'll still have a little bit of summer stuff going forward, but the winter stuff for now will be all of that kind of stuff. So all your radishes, your leeks, your scallions. We'll have celery root. Celery won't last too much longer. Of course, all your storage crops, potatoes, onions, Jerusalem artichokes. We'll have Brussels sprouts for a while. Of course, carrots galore. And all of your winter radishes and your turnips and beets. Lettuce we'll have for a little while longer. The lettuce is a lot of different kinds of greens, but all of your summer stuff, peppers and whatever, will only be what we have in storage until they run out, which is probably another 10 days at the most. And we'll have a few straggler tomatoes that we picked early, so good time for fried green tomatoes. But it's time to go to the seasonal stuff.
Rutabaga, how can I forget?
Rutabaga. Actually, it's really, if you know how to cook it, it's really tasty stuff. Parsnips.
How do you like it?
Yeah, there's a way, but I don't know how they cook it in the Middle East. They dice it into small and then they cook it and then they put cilantro and lemon juice and it's like a kind of a, how am I going to put it? Not a sauce, but it's like a side dish that you eat it with other stuff. I've had it mashed and I like it mashed, but I don't know how they cooked it. I just ate it.
Fair enough. This is one of my favorites. I like that it looks like a heart, more or less.
You're going to have to eat it.
But I put it into soup.
So, here, let
goodbye
me go
for now, and we'll see everybody in the spring. Have a great winter, and keep in touch. Thank you.
Thanks for the season.
Thank you.